Welcome everyone to today's video. So some months ago, I installed here this tempered glassing, and today is a 2 month update. And as you can see, unfortunately, all this hardened tempered glass stuff is breaking off here at the corner. And this is not even used so much. So the only thing is I tested this with some keys in my pocket, probably sometimes in my jeans pocket. Somewhere like this, so I think I tried to have it on the plastic side here. I did not even walk and travel around so much, so most of the day this is laying on my office desk and only in the morning and evening for a short walk to the office and such. I think I used it relatively little, and for this little, in my opinion, this is already quite much damage from some really hardened tempered glass. I would have expected more, not that all this stuff breaks off there at the corner already after just 2 months, and the first cracks here were already in the first week. So after just 7 days I started to have the first cracks here, and then after 1 month it was half of this, and now it's 2 months gone. So yeah, and also here, probably due to some small cracks there, it's already some air bubble there. And you see how it starts at the bottom, is some very small piece at the border. So at least this kind of no name tempered glassing I unfortunately can't recommend. The only good thing I can say about this is that at least here on the main display area it does not have any scratches or so, but it does not help as much if all your border is cracking away. Unfortunately I don't have a macro lens, so don't forget to share, like and subscribe, that in the future I can afford a macro lens for this kind of filming. So as we are already here, let's try to do some intentional testing here that actually did not do too much. Maybe can we do this more controlled? I hope this is in focus, at least in manually macro focus. So let's test here on some area. So at least scratch wise it appears to be quite hard. So even this sharper stainless steel knife here does not really leave visible scratches here. Let's see it. So actually scratch wise, as you can see, even with intentionally scratching, it is quite resistant to that, but this helps little if all the border is chipping away like this. If you have higher quality AAA brand recommendation, let me know. At least this no name thing is not that awesome in this regard. I will probably leave this here some more weeks or months until I can't see this here anymore to protect the display. But yeah, eventually I have to dispose this here then, unfortunately. One slightly different recommendation. So after some weeks, this plastic got a little bit too boring for me. Also, by the way, I still need to file this here a little bit because a headphone plug does not fully plug in here. I usually press the plastic down a little bit. But if you have this problem, obviously just take a file and file off a little bit. I, however, found this a little bit too boring after a week or two, and instead got here something much more alternative here, this G-Star Raw jeans kind of thing, because this just looked too cheap and boring. And this G-Star Raw thing here, so far I used this already a month or so. So this scratches here are only from 1 month. The other month I used this, and this actually is relatively tight to press in. This is one of the most tight cases, and I actually grew to like this jeans look quite a bit. Here you can put cards in, and the only thing I don't like so much is a supersized lensing for the newer iPhones. On this older iPhone this looks a little bit out of place, and although it looks tight on this one, actually the headphone jack fits in fully compared to the other one. And yeah, maybe you like this, maybe not. Anyway, so I thought I'd let you know about this chipping thing here. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe also that I can afford a macro lens in the future. And I hope to see you soon for the next videos to come.